I'm glad that you're here. I'm just checking you out.
Do I look okay?
You look
okay.
Nice. I mean, you're single.
Yeah, because
I was looking. I always like to look out, you know, for the ladies who
are watching. Yeah, you guys are very looking out. Probably about 315 pounds.
Yeah. You know, you're just as good looking as the guy Clayton who played you in the movie.
We look kind of different, but you know, they did a great job of picking out the character, though.
You look different, but you're both attractive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what I like to hear.
Yeah. So, you didn't do any press for the Blind Side movie. I was kind of shocked at that.
Yeah. My first NFL season. The type that I like to stay focused and football is first, and that's my main love. That's the reason I'm here.
Yeah.
Football, so I wanted to stay away from that, and you guys spelled my name wrong, by the way. OATR.
OATR.
Yeah, but.
Oh. We spelled like O, like O in the water.
Yeah.
So,
I didn't want to do any press. Just stay focused and, help us win games.
Yeah. Well, you also seem like a shy guy.
I probably came across that, side in the Blind Side, but once you get to know me, open up a little bit, yeah, let loose.
So, you played for the Baltimore Ravens, and, what's the difference between, some of the differences, I know you can't explain everything, but, you explain everything in your book. What is the difference between the story that we saw in the movies with Sandra Bullock and the story that's the real deal, that's you?
I think that instilled, how much, determination and, will power that I had myself and, drive I had deep down inside to make it on my own. I never necessarily needed a worker come and save me. I was going to, be something on my own, even if I had to, work in restaurants or, anything. I was going to get out there, drive out of my own.
You feel like they portrayed you as being a bit of a dumbbell in the movie.
Yeah, I always, pride myself on being a, smart, intelligent guy and, tried to do the right thing growing up, stay away from, gangs, violence, everything like that.
Yeah. Your foster parents have been guests on the show before.
Yeah.
They were really nice people. They never exactly said how they made money. I think I forgot to ask them that question. But then I did a little research. I found that they own a bunch of Taco Bells and stuff.
They make pretty good money.
Yeah.
They didn't need the money, taking me in or anything like that.
But another thing that they didn't show in the movie is that you weren't the only foster child that they took in. There were other foster kids
in
the house.
Guys from the schools would go spend the night over there if they needed, rides, anything like that. So they got a big heart, and, I just lived with them permanent and, moved in, and, we connected right off. It was a lot of love.
The Tuohy family, Mr. and Mrs. Tuohy, do you call them by their, mom and dad, do you call them now that you're grown and ready on your own?
Oh, we talk every day. It depends. Yeah. I call them whatever. If I'm mad at them, call them by their name.
Yeah.
It all depends. So, yeah.
So your first NFL contract was for like $13 million, right? Listen, I just like to put that out there.
You tell my business.
I want to check you out on the internet.
I see. They need to get rid of some of that stuff.
I wanted to make sure that it's understood that, you came up on your own.
Yeah.
You're really the fabulous people. But what did you do with your first paycheck? Part of it, anyway.
Yeah, I bought a car. I bought a BMW, 750 BMW.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, do you have a relationship with your biological mother? Because she was on drugs on and off.
Yeah. We don't have a relationship that we once had. She's still trying to get better and working hard. And hopefully in the future we get that same bond that we once had.
Yeah. You keep the door open with that.
Yeah.
Now you have a lot of biological brothers and sisters,
yeah.
Like 10 of them?
There's 12 of us.
12 siblings.
Yeah.
5 siblings.
Yeah.
Are you in touch with them?
Yeah, I keep contact with everybody. I always see them, and I came to a few of my games, came to a lot of my games in college, and we still talk and everything. So yeah.
That's nice. Do you have a girlfriend?
You know, keep my personal life, you know.
Okay, after the show, I'll just jump on the computer.
You'll find some on the internet.
Yeah, you know it. And then we'll talk about it on Monday. Michael, it was so nice to meet you. You're really good sport for laughing along with us. And your story is really inspirational. Thank you for coming. And congratulations on everything. Everybody, Michael Orr, right here. And his book is called I Beat to Us. And it's available in bookstores everywhere, and everyone in the studio audience is getting their copy. We'll be right back.
At Mattress Discounters, we do.